money of God, I trust, and I stay high like wedding blunts. Car ain't got no roof, ducking down like I'm a troop. It's a murder when we shoot, and I'm so hot like overdue. Like a sneeze, God bless you, they be on me like I'm blue. Little do they know that I'm bad news, until my mugshot be up in the news. I'm true to my religion, facts are never fiction. Can't call me a Christian, cause I'm never into forgiving. I'm living, I know that I can scream. Whoa. I already know that you spreading lies on the block. So I suppose that you choose another lane, because your only way to fame is defecating on another man's name. That's insane.
I know that I can scream it.
Because that's the only way they're going to win on this Independent Music Awards. You can't just sit there and hope she's going to win. So without further ado, let's bring out Monica in his house.
What's up? What's up? They call me Monica. They call me Momo. They call me Honey, but it's Monique Lenore.
They call you Honey.
Honey.
We were just watching you when we were coming over here on the, taking photos and... The one thing I like about you, you do promote.
Promotion is key, baby. Nobody don't know what's going on.
Right now. She's like, you know what? She forgot she on live. She promoted right now.
Nah, I know I'm live, but I'm posting that, you know, you need to vote. So if I don't post what you just said, I ain't going to get no votes.
I like that.
Ain't no time like the present.
Hey, you got to vote on there and hit our song. But we were just playing your song. Tell me a little bit about it.
First of all, that song was produced by McBoo, that dope music producer. He is cousins with DJ D-Nice. Everybody knows D-Nice. McBoo and I have been working for about 8.5 years. We have a lot of music. He's one of the main producers I work with. I mean, to be myself. When I go to the studio, I'm able to say what I want to say, do what I want to do, and clean it up later. You know, some people are very, like, anal. They want to micromanage everything you do. And my thing is my creativity. Yeah. I'm not, everyone's like, oh, you're not an artist. You don't know this person's song. You don't know how many did it. Listen, my creativity comes from a spirit within me that does music, lives for music, believes in music, breathes music. So I'm not going to know what everybody's doing because I'm busy working on what I'm doing. So it's going to be difficult for everybody in the record industry to accept me because I don't follow the rules. I don't play by the rules. I don't know the rules, but I know that Bring 'Em Out has that music that touches my soul. So that song, Ready for This, is saying they ain't ready for this. They not ready for this. So you might as well listen to that a couple times and you still ain't going to be ready because I'm going to switch it up the next time.
I like that. You keep them wanting and guessing and things like that.
Right.
It's a good thing, you know, on your song. But I heard the song and I, it's like it dawned on me. I was like, oh, okay. I hear a little bit of rapping in there and everything.
So. Yeah. I'm doing everything light. You know, I'm starting off light. I'm just going by my vibe. A lot of people are looking forward to my videos. My videos are very creative. Right. I'm very involved in my music videos. I love the video guy I work with, director Jamal Hall. He did This Love For Me, which is on YouTube. And, you know, a lot of people are like, well, why is that your only video? You know, a lot goes into my videos. For this video, I really have a specific vibe I'm looking for. And I've reached out to a couple people to shoot the video, and they are very, what's the word? They're very unwilling to change their opinion because they're looking at me like, are you saying you hold me down, baby girl, and that's why? You know, are you gay? Are you straight? You know, so a lot of controversy goes into the record in the fact that I say you hold me down, baby girl. And we'll get more into that as depth into the video. Right. I'm saving it for the video. But the bottom line is that I am not a stereotype or a classification or a category. I'm Monique Lenore. I'm going to constantly keep you entertained. I'm an entertainer. The world has not seen an entertainer like me.
And I like that because get with the program. That's all I gotta say.
Word.
You know what I'm saying? Get with the program.
Where's that
2016? You know, right. They having homosexuals and everything on TV. People saying different. Come on, man. If guys or girls put it like that cannot get over a word.
Right.
They need to step into a reality.
It was hurtful in the beginning, you know, because I am very much a drill sergeant, and I like things done when I like it done, especially when I'm ready. Like, if I'm fleeked, makeup done, hair done, right, I'm ready to do the video right now. And, you know, I don't like to hear no. I haven't got off understanding the word no, because, you know, no may not be no. No may be you're not the one. No may be not right now. You know, I'm hearing this, you know, I'm hearing your beautiful radio station, and I'm here with John. John is a person that believes in me. The world hasn't seen him. I keep him on the back end, but he's in the
front. They see him now, though.
They see him now. He's on the forefront. John is a person that believes in my creativity. It took a long time to find somebody that was a financial person, an advisor, a friend who knew music in and out. You know, it was just me and Bring Him Out. So it was very difficult with me and just me and Bring Him Out. We can't do so much. We needed to expand the team, but I always believe in the right timing for everything, you know. And John came along and he believed, like, you know, not into the words or the music, but in the idea of allowing a person to be themselves and supporting that person in getting where they want to go. You know, a lot of radio stations, a lot of DJs, they're like, who got the bag? Who gonna drop the bag on me? You know, I'll play all your music if you drop the bag. I'm on a, why should I drop the bag on you?
Right.
You know what I mean? Unfortunately, the bags are here. Why should they be dropped, though? Because if I have to pay you to play my music, then I don't know if I want you to play my music.
You know what? Me and my publishers, my directors and stuff, we say that all the time. And some people are like, wait, you got people on your show and you don't charge them? Why would I charge someone to be on my show? I never understood that. And why would I charge them to play music on my radio? Because it's for them as well as for us. So we're both, you know, benefiting it.
Yeah.
We're getting known, and we're getting known as well.
And someone has to hear it here first.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, there's not that you will never charge to be on your radio station, because at the end of the day, your time may be taken up after dropping my songs. You might not have no time to drop nobody else's music. They may have to drop the bags. But at the same time, it's about starting off on the people the opportunity to be creative and to show their talent on your show. Everyone needs a platform. So honestly, a lot of people are like, you know, Monique, you look cute, but you broke, and you know, cute and broke don't go together. You can say whatever you want. I don't look broke. I may be broke. My purse may be real. My purse may be fake. That's for y'all to do all that. My job is to let you know I'm on a no money challenge. That's my hashtag. No money challenge. How far can I get spending no money? Now, yes, my makeup costs money. My hair costs money. The Uber costs money. But I'm saying no money challenge, meaning that talent should shine before the bags. I'm sick of seeing artists that, you know, banked $100,000 because they were an escort on Backpage.com. And so now they're dropping songs before me because they were whoring and I wasn't. It's like, this is not a competition. Go whores. I support you. But at the same time, I really want to show for my talent.
Yeah, and we have a thing we have every year called Music in the Gardens, and that's the reason why. We have over 12 performers come in, different singers, type of singers. At their time, we pay for you know, the plays, the music and stuff. They come in and perform for free for the community, and they love it. We're on our third year now.
Wow.
And everyone's already, like, pretty much...
I need to be down. I need to be on that. I need to be on that.
Yeah, music in the garden. We have nothing but woman power, which is our third year. And female artists come on their free time and perform for the community, and they say the same thing. They need platforms like this where they don't have to pay, we don't have to pay, and we're just joining together to say, listen, that's why we made the Independent Music Awards. Because we said, wait a minute, well, these independent artists are out there, they need something to be heard. And
I want to say shout out to Lawrence Miles. I don't know if he's listening. Hopefully we can get a copy of this and I can repost some of these things tomorrow. But VIP Ben, Lawrence Miles, is the reason that I'm here and I'm meeting you guys today. He works out at the Women's Chambers of Commerce. He's constantly in the streets. He's constantly looking at women and trying to support them and plug them in and help them. He's not charging any money. He's doing this from the kindness of his heart. So shout out.
He'll be here, I think, in 2 weeks. Yeah. He actually switched. He was like, hey, let her shine, and I'll come in another 2 weeks or so.
That's love.
You know, and that's why.
And that's no money, and no, we didn't sleep together. So it's no money, no honey either. Okay? We trying to get through with talents. People have talents and they needed a platform that they're safe and they're able to, you know, not be exploited. They're able to just shine. And if they're declined, that is the okay answer. It's not that everyone is going to be loved and accepted and embraced and be, number one, you know, but at least you have the opportunity to say your story.
Yes. Well, how many contests that's on TV and people don't win and then they become big stars? Or because they didn't win that doesn't mean nothing. You know, or because they didn't get heard doesn't mean nothing. Just keep on pushing and pushing. That's what I always say.
I'm not really good at pushing. I'm going to be honest. I'm lazy. I should have been on. I turned down offers all day. Today's Thursday. You know, I'm supposed to be after this. Supposedly the plan was from here, going to New Jersey, recording with a Grammy Award winning producer, you know, a DJ radio personality who was going to remix a song that I already did and make it number one. And they constantly have turned me down, failed, canceled, rescheduled, this, that. Oh, you going to the radio show? What's that? You ain't getting paid to do that. I get it. People are stuck in their ways. Those people are fine in someone else's world. In my world, it's not what you say or what you do. It's my vibe. If you and me don't have the vibe, it ain't going to work out. You know what I mean? When I was on my way over here, Wade said it was going to take us 2 hours to get to the radio show. I was like, John, nope. We need to get there in an hour. According to Waze, it was impossible. Wow. But here I am. Because there is a possibility to break the code. You know, and that's what I want to show, is that one thing, that one person that slipped through the cracks and everybody slept on them.
Yeah.
You know?
And now they just heard the music. They're hearing it over the radio, Newstream, iTunes, you tune in, our website. And then it gets replayed on Manhattan Network, soon on the Bronx Net.
Hey!
Stays on our webpage, on our YouTube channel. So,
aww,
that one trip just caused you. And we're not, not to tap myself in the back, but we announced that we just went 160% more viewers than last
week. Woo!
So,
big up!
It's the numbers. I had to double check the numbers because me and my public relations, we looked at the numbers twice. And I'm like,
right, because you didn't understand. It felt like the Empire moment when the numbers went up.
Wait a minute, double check this. And we double checked it. And we hit it again. And
yes.
And I think that's wrong.
No, you got the honey bee in the building. You know what? That's popping, man.
We went from live celebrities watching like 63, 70, because live is sometimes hard.
Okay.
Pre-recorded, it goes way up.
Right.
We went from 63 last time to almost 200 or something. So now that we have almost every month close to 6,000 to 7,000.
Nice.
So it's like,
Nice.
And why? It's because we want to bring out the best in everyone. So everyone's like, okay, who's this independent artist?
Nice. Right. It's a new thing. It's a new... Listen, A&Rs, people who are scouting talent, need to get down with the LDM show and need to know what's going on. I mean, I'm fortunate. I'm family now. I walked in the building and I met your producer, and he's from Montserrat. It's only 4,900 of us Montserratians worldwide. It's Angela Yee, him and me. That's it.
That's it. That's it.
So you know, when you walk through the door in a place you've never been, I'm on Snapchat like the Bronx. I've never even been to White Plains Road. I'm looking at these filters like, oh my God, lock the door, John, lock the door. I don't know what's going to happen to us, you know. But I walk in the door and it's like, I'm at home. Food, drinks, water, whatever you need, you know. And I'm like, you know what, that's love, you know.
It was always, because someone gave me a start, like I said, because I was starting off at LDM News, and I was by my seat with Channel 7, CBS, and I'm with a little tiny-ass camera trying to talk about... Yeah, but what about? And they're looking at me like, okay, you're stupid. And then I said, you know what? I'm going to try to take a chance and go to one of the celebrities, which is Jim Carrey. He was doing a book. His manager said, nah, he's kind of busy today.
He's busy today.
And I see him going to CBS and all that. And I'm like, so he looks at me and said, hey, how can I help? I said, hey, I got a couple questions. And
word.
More longer than he did with the news.
That exactly. Real.
So
real recognized real.
Has to give a thing. And ever since then, we went and we did the LDM show. My producer came along. I made him produce for us, direct. He actually did PR. He's mostly everything. He's just different hat all the time.
And he's from Montserrat, no. Just like me. That's how we get it.
Who's also here. She does a lot, directs. Like I said, lately she's been my agent, sending me to radio stations, sending me here.
Nice.
So
big up to your wife and your beautiful baby. Congratulations. That's the first thing I saw, is your family is right here supporting you, and this is a great opportunity. I'm so honored to be here.
We're honored to have you. But we're going to take a quick commercial break, but they'll come back.
Yeah, I need another drink. I need another drink.
More about you, where you're from, what you're doing, and what's your next steps. Let's hear a little bit about a little bit of the radio. This is the LDM Show Radio, where all the indies are going to be at. And you guys got to, it's 24 hours, 7 days a week. Come on, when you're not doing nothing, turn on the radio and listen to some good music.
Well, here we go. We're back here at the LDM show. Hey. We got Brooklyn in the house,
Brooklyn,
I guess.
Brooklyn in the house right now, Marine Park in the house, Crown Heights in the house.
That's how it goes, you know. But we're spending a good time here learning a little bit about you, and we're going to be learning a little bit more. So you guys that are watching us, again, thank you for watching, as well as supporting the independent artist. So
yes,
that's a good thing. Check her out. Check her music out. Videos coming up.
Please
and all
check
that.
Me out. SoundCloud, Monique Lenore. YouTube, Monique Lenore. Facebook, Monique Lenore. Now call me Monica, you know. Monique.
I like that. Well, for you guys that were guessing, she is... from?
Montserrat, no! Yo, I really say that because right now I'm working on a record right now with you. It's going to like blow the world up. I'm working with Easy Mo B right now. Easy Mo B and I are doing a record. The record is called Paper. The record is done. The record, we just went album artwork. It's coming soon. When I come back to this radio show, we're going to bust these airwaves down. Easy Mo B has done Tupac, Biggie, Alicia Keys, Queen Latifah, and now Easy Mo B and Jonathan Pemberton have done a digital distribution deal with MyTunes, and they are going to have me, Monique Lenore, the first artist coming out on that digital distribution team. Can I get some horns? Boom, boom, boom.
That is what's going on.
So I need... So at the end of the day, I'm very excited about Paper. It's a very hard record. Easy Mo B doesn't do little bit of, you know, stuff. We don't do no auto-tune. We don't do none of that. Right. And I'm telling you, I'm very excited. Not just working with, you know, Bring Him Out. Not just working with him. I'm working with a lot of people. Anybody who sends me a record, I'm writing to their record. I wouldn't care if you email me a record from China. And the thing is, in horns, a Chinese beat, I'm going to make you a song because right. I believe in music. And right now, I'm very excited to say that if I have a platform like this mm-hmm. to put out more music, I'm going to be putting it out.
Oh, yeah, bring it out. Like I said, LDM Show, the LDM Radio, Independent Music Awards. And I'm sending you out an invitation right now for, when is Nothing But Woman Power? July or August of 2017. Write that down. We're sending you the first invitation coming out right now.
I already accept. I come with my cousin to produce. I come in.
There we go. And that is also live, and it's also pre-recorded for the TV channels. So, and this year, I think, don't quote me, but I think it's supposed to be a little bit bigger than last year. We try to make it bigger every year. So big ups to all y'all women that do all this. So that's a real good thing. And music in the garden. So if you want to do both.
I'm doing both. Let me tell you, Charles, me, August, you, right? The producer, your wife, the baby, we all going to be everywhere. We're not stopping until we get this to the next level. Until someone comes in here with the bag to drop on us, to shut us down because we're making too much noise.
Hey,
I'm ready to take LDM Show to the next level. Yeah. You need somebody to talk like the Soldier Sisters is going down. At the end of the day, I know for sure that you guys are supportive. And I know that this is where I'm going to break the paper record with Easy Mo B. I'm promising you guys, I'm bringing Easy Mo B to this studio to paper live so that the world can hear that we are not playing right now with this music game.
Oh, we got platforms for live performances on the side. So you can perform live if you want, have a lot of fun. But, you know, records like this, and independent artists like yourself that pushing, it's good. But we were talking about a little bit about social media and how does it affect indie artists, or how does it affect anyone, basically?
First of all, let me say this. As a woman, it is very difficult. You can't even find a person to take a picture of you. Right. You can't find a person to record you. You can't find a person to support you. You can't find a person to come to your show. So sometimes I'm doing stuff, I'm entertaining, and I have no proof. So the first thing when you go to the record companies, they're like, well, where's your proof?
Right.
What have you done? What shows have you done? And you have nobody to support you. Let me tell you something. Someone sent me a DM that said, the people that's going to make you rich are not your friends. Your money is going to come from strangers. And, you know, that really humbled me, you know, because shout out to Mo Bacavelli. She let me know, like, stop complaining about the people who are not supporting you, and push past that and get it happening, get it cracking. Because the people that's going to make you rich don't even know your name, where you're from, or anything. That is something I'm trying to drop on you. Social media, a lot of people on social media push, follow me, tune into my radio show, do this. They're not going to do it. You know what I'm saying? Because it's by chance that a person that's actually not a spectator in your life, a person that's actually someone in your corner trying to see you win, they're not home spectating. They're sitting right here with you. You know what I'm saying? Taking pictures, taking videos of you.
Just like the gentleman next to you.
Just like John. You know what I'm saying? A person that will, like John, call off of work and like, excuse me, work. We going over here. He said sick. That's exactly what he said. He said I'm sick.
I did that one time to support an indie artist. I can't really go that day.
That's crazy that you say that, because we were in the car speeding up the FDR drive, and I'm like, John, you supposed to be at work. He like, nope, I'm supporting an independent artist and a friend that's going to get to the next level, and I'm going to see that happen. And here we are. You know what I'm saying? So my thing is with social media, on social media, do not post, watch me, view me, buy this, buy that, post, see you when I see you, you know, because those are the people that's going to be calling you to get the ticket. Today, my phone is dead. It's on 10%. Every day, I don't get a phone call, an email, nothing. No one comes to the shows. You know why? Right. Because I'm not in their face like that.
Right.
They don't see that I'm boasting or, you know, bragging. But today, I'm boasting and bragging. Thank you for removing yourself from my life. Those are less people I have to support in the future.
That's so funny you say that. I was trying to look for a friend of mine's text, something, And I replied to that. You don't get nowhere worrying about what people say. Just live your life and worry about the ones that have a positive. If you want to say something to me positive. And we have this thing where in LDM, we say hashtag hate to say what.
Hate to say what?
And the reason why we say that is because in the beginning, there's always haters. And now there is still haters. But we embrace the haters because we say without the haters, we will not get famous. Because what happens when the haters be like, oh, look at Charles and his show. What show? Oh, he think he all good because he's on the LDM show. What they do? They go on the LDM show to find out.
What are you doing?
Let me tell you,
I believe you, Charles, that what you're doing is definitely right. I feel like when you're on the right path, you don't slip. Mm-hmm. Because to slip and slide fast, it means you're sliding down. Mm-hmm. So go up, there is resistance if you're on the right path.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll tell you right now that when I went to Mac at Barclays Center, all black women, Latina women, white women, don't go to Mac at Barclays Center. I went to Barclays Center Mac to get my face done, and they removed me with security and the police. They tried to get me arrested on my way to your show, talking about I was aggressive, and they felt unsafe around me because the assistant manager asked me, why am I not smiling when I'm getting my makeup done? I said, miss, if I wasn't going to the radio station today, you and your store would be turned upside down because I'm trying to get my face done. Mm-hmm. The lady said, I feel your tone is very aggressive. I feel you're attacking me. And she contacted 911 and the security to pull me out physically of Barclays Center. And anybody that know Monique Lenore, Easy Mo B, you name them, they know I ain't an innocent individual.
Hey.
I'm a Brooklyn chick all day and night. I'm the thug that the glass group that came in here, their manager had to experience a little bit of my thugness because they realized I'm from Brooklyn. I don't play that.
Which is good. You know.
I got my face done at Macy's, okay? It is very difficult in my life as a woman to let people know they have to respect me.
I like that.
You know, they have
from
to respect me.
You're like telling them, listen, I'm with you, but respect. That's what we all about. And like, because like I was saying, we believe in that. That's why we say hate to say what. Because the more we go up there, I always end my thing with the hashtag.
Haters say what?
Because
and that's
that means
what
look
I
at
love.
Me now. Because you're saying all these things about us and look at where we're going.
Exactly.
I don't care what people say because the more you say, the more I'm going to do.
Right.
If you say I can't do it, guess what? I'm going to do it.
Exactly.
You know, we made changes in our show. It's not going to happen. Like I said, 160% more than on last month. And we're just going to rise and rise and rise.
And it's crazy because this is my second time on radio. I should be on radio every day, TV every day. I'm chilling. I'm taking a humble road. I'm trying to work on my craft before you try to be in a spotlight. A lot of people don't realize that they try to jump in the spotlight with their half-assed stuff and they don't be ready. And even coming to this radio show, I was attacked. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, publicly on you guys' page, I was getting DM'd like crazy about my copyright infringement and all these type of threats. See you at your show Thursday. I'm right here, right live, and I'm telling you like this. Be careful who you threaten because some people show up and show out. And I'm here today looking fleeked out, being a woman, handling my business. I'm not easily intimidated. I am not a hood rat. I'm not a thug, but I stand up behind my music 100%.
Your music is real good. Like I said, I was listening to it as well. And you guys can listen to it too. Just go on her page as well. Or listen to it on the radio. Either or.
Or live. Don't make me sing for you.
Hey.
I might sing your pants off.
Ooh, yeah.
You know I'm a raspy alto. Ain't a lot of altos left.
That's true.
You know my competition is very low. Because there ain't no auto-tune live. So don't test me.
So, how long have you been singing, and have you been singing the same type of music, or you changed?
So, I've been singing since I was 4 years old. My mother and father were in the 80s, and they were, you know, dealing with drugs and alcohol, addicted to crack cocaine. I was born in Woodhall Hospital. I was a seizuring child. I wasn't supposed to make it. My mother gave her life to God that day when she pushed me out and said, Lord, if you deliver my child, I will never do drugs. I will never do secular music. I will never do anything not to serve you. 32 years later, because I'm 32 years old, Right. My mother has never given up on God. My life was spared. My mother is a minister of music, a pastor. Her name is Audrey Veach. She has, you know, entered a program called New Life for Girls. She changed her entire life around, and she taught me how to sing since 4 years old. She has been at Carnegie Hall. She has traveled the world saving lives for God, and she has instilled in me that if you're going to make a musical tune or make any music, make it to have some type of meaning. Have a message to what you say. My mother doesn't condone me drinking or cursing or being promiscuous or taking pictures, you know, halfway nude, but she respects that I am an individual who is doing something that I love. She believes in my dream. She supports my dream, and she taught me how to sing. And that lady, her name is Audrey Veach. You go on YouTube or anywhere, she is changing women's lives and restoring families for the good of God's love and grace. And with that being said, I'm not afraid of anybody. I'm not afraid of anything, because I've seen both of my parents never touch crack ever again from the day that I was born. And that's amazing.
And that's a blessing. That's a big time blessing to do something like that and to keep it going.
Yes.
And then with you wanting to be where you want to go, it's a blessing. She probably smiling like, yeah, she's on the radio.
If she listening, but I'm gonna get a copy of this and send it to her, because she needs to understand that she has made such an impact in my life. You know, her going and singing, I would see people stop. People put money in donation bins. People support, you know, us, our family, and the ministry based on a song she would sing, not even knowing who she was. And based on that, I'm like, yo, I'm not the best Christian in the world, but if you could sing a song and change someone's life, you better sing. You know, I love to rap. A lot of people don't like that I rap because they feel like I don't have metaphors. I don't have those punch lines where I'm battle rapping. But trust me, the music that's coming out is going to speak for itself. I'm very happy about the music that's coming out.
I like that. And you guys got to check her out. We're running a little bit out of time, but you got to check her out as much as possible. We're going to be playing her song again. But again, go online, vote for her. TheLDMShow.com/vote, or just click on the radio station and click on the vote. As much votes as you can get. And then next year, probably be a nominee, win. Elections where we're going to be voting. Woman of the Year, Artist of the Year. There's a lot of, right? Yeah, almost 32 to 35 different categories.
Listen, I don't know if I'm going to make it, but I know one thing. Montserrat, no!
Hey, there you go.
Thank you, guys.
Just let them know where they can find you a little bit.
Find me through Charles. Just contact Charles and he'll contact me.
Hey, you need her for any music, for anything, let us know. That's what we do. We connect a lot of the artists that'll be here with the right people. And I mean the right people, because we screen them first. And we make sure. We're not going to send no one to someone that's not real good. If you're sending us your music, and you want to say, hey, I didn't accept your music online, or like you said, social media, please say why. Because we do have guidelines. We do not like cursing. We do not like downgrading of females. And we do not like other songs type of things. So there's a couple guidelines that were not accepted to be on our radio station. So, you know, pretty much be good. In other words, for you to be on our radio station. But that was our time, and we had a good time with her. We also have Girl Talk.
Nice.
So we'll talk about it, and you can probably be a guest panel on Girl Talk. There's only girls talking about girl stuff.
Everybody's going to sleep now, right? So I got some good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go. Good night.
There we go. Let's go. We're about to leave here. Check it out. Stay tuned for her on Girl Talk and everything else. This is Charles Aloma. This is the LDM Show. Independent artists. This is where you got to be. Check them out. Independent Music Awards and everything else.
That music. I know that I can scream it with joy. You can handle.
me in the form of no bus. Getting money in God, I trust, and I stay high like where them blunts. Car ain't got no roof, ducking down like I'm a troop. It's a murder when we shootin', I'm so hot like overdue. Like to sneeze, God bless you. They be on me like I'm blue. Little do they know that I'm bad news until my mugshot be up in the news. I'm true to my religion. Facts are never fiction. Can't call me a Christian, cause I'm never into forgiving. I'm living.
I know that I can scream it.
Whoa. I already know that you spreading lies on the block. So I suppose that you choose another lane, because your only way to fame is defecating on another man's name. That's insane.
I know that I can scream it.
Watching the LDM show, let us know what you think about this episode. Hit us up on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. We value your opinion, so please let us know.